blog. How are you doing?
All right. So, Jesse, we got Hunter here, special guest.
Hunter swagging.
Hey.
Hey.
Hey, what's up?
There's some boxes down there. We are starting to pack up the campus to get ready for
the Lithopolis campus.
Mm-hmm. Lithopolis campus.
Goodbye.
And so we need to go over to the Old Blue Rooster. Yeah, that's where we did middle school, and get that stuff out.
Yeah. So all you Lancaster peeps that have heard us talk about the Old Blue Rooster like a million times, you're gonna get to see what it looks like.
Yeah. It's gonna be sad. Like rip. That's like our place. Psych. I'm gonna be glad that we're not gonna be setting up anymore. We'll actually have a room.
Yeah, that's true.
The Old Blue Rooster was actually really nice. They cut us a deal and all that good stuff. Yeah.
Take a golf cart.
Keep going. You're good. You're good. You're good.
What happened?
So I bought my dad for Father's Day like a power washer extension. He doesn't have a power washer.
It's like, no.
I bought this $150 DeWalt like pressure washer attachment.
Yeah.
I thought it was like just like a mini power washer, but it's an attachment for your power washer. So now my dad has to go buy a power washer.
All right, so who knows if you heard any of that? Probably not, because of the wind. But this is the Old Blue Rooster. Lancaster kids, this is where the Litho gang had their middle school experience. So we were coming over here to get stuff. And stuff was, what was our stuff?
A big TV.
Yeah, TV. A TV. Oh, I like this.
Where's the stuff?
But yeah, so
this is where middle school happened. In this room right here.
What the heck?
Okay. So we came over here to get a TV, and the TV's not in here, because the same way in Lancaster, we used to watch our vlogs on a TV before we moved into the new room. You know, we moved into a new room like 2 weeks before quarantine happened. Oh, he's found it. That's weird.
Bring the cart down here.
Okay, no. Yep. Mm-hmm. So we found the TV. Never mind. Whatever. Crisis averted.
Put her in reverse.
Oh, that door's open. I should probably close that. Alright. Keys off. That was embarrassing.
Alright. We found the TV. There they are.
They're in there.
The TV has a big scratch on it. It's right there. Can you see it?
Somehow we're gonna put this TV on this golf cart and drive it back over.
Ah! We're here.
So today we're gonna talk about wisdom, and just to kick this thing off, wisdom would say that we're probably not gonna safely put this thing on this golf cart. But that's just me. This is tribute to the years that this building has given us. The beauty, the memories, the salvation of Christ.
think we need to do the...
Alright, so you can't hear me because the wind was bad, but it was an honorable tribute to this building. It was beautiful. And then here, we're discussing on how to get the TV back to the church. And we decided to get the TV and roll it on the side. And we're rolling it, and we're rolling it. And we can't use the audio because it was so windy and it sounds horrible. But we're rolling it, and we're rolling it. And we got caught by a rock, and they almost dropped it, which was horrible. But then after that, we kept going, and you'll see the rest. And then we came across this van that was in the driveway, and we were laughing so hard because we're wondering what this guy was thinking when he sees a couple of guys on a golf cart rolling a TV onto the road. We checked both ways, we were safe, and we went back onto our driveway for the church, and then we started rolling it back up, and we were safe.
TV stand has ever rolled that far.
So Westinghouse,
or fast.
Dang good job.
Rolled that far or fast.
Well, or sister.
The TV is safe now. It's back at the church. I'm not going to tell you where it's at because you guys are thieves. So I can get that golf cart in there. Bada bing, bada boom. We're done. It's so sad. So sad. We're out of the old Blue Rooster. But it's kind of cool because now we get to have our own youth room, just like Lancaster.
Well, that's a close one. Okay, see you, Hunter.
Got your drinks.
No!
Hey! These are... I'm thirsty. And... Okay.
So we're going to talk about wisdom. There's in this world with social media, the news, all this stuff that's dividing us, there's a lot of things going on, and it's hard sometimes to receive stuff as truth. Like, you hear something, you're like, oh man, I can't believe that happened. And then you realize, you tell your friend that fact or what happened, and they're like, that didn't happen. And you're like, oh, okay. Are you zooming in? But there's a lot of stuff, a lot of information that gets thrown at us. And we use wisdom, and you can use wisdom to decide, okay, what's truth? Like, what's something that I should listen to? What's something that I should receive? And what's something I shouldn't? That's what wisdom is deciding, okay, what is a lie and what is truth? And so we want to encourage you guys, use wisdom in these times where facts are being thrown around or opinions are being thrown around, to make sure that you filter that through and you're not just accepting everything that's thrown at you, because then that's where you hear the old saying, it's true because the internet said it. So don't be that person. Think for yourself.
Meep.
Sunglasses inside.
James 1 verse 5 says, if any of you lacks wisdom, you should ask God, who gives generously to all without finding fault, and it will be given to you.
So Jesse,
good stuff.
What does that mean?
So what that means is that if we are in a situation where we feel like we don't quite understand what's happening, or we feel like we need God to help us understand maybe what's going on in any kind of situation, all we have to do is ask. Simple as that.
So use wisdom. If you don't have wisdom, ask God for it. You're like, all right, God, I need some more wisdom. That's what Solomon did, King Solomon.
And he was said to be the wisest man to ever live.
Was he wise before he asked for wisdom? Like, was he wise because he asked God, or was he wise because he asked God and then he got the wisdom?
What?
Never mind. Yeah, but use wisdom, guys. You can ask God. That's a promise. Ask God for wisdom and think for yourself. But until then, that's this week's vlog. Thanks for watching. Sorry, the TV didn't get smashed. It is episode 75.
Thank you guys for watching episode 75. We will see you next week.
Oh, yeah.